Hi, I'm Mithilesh. Today, we're gonna look up circles. We will see different situations that can arise when a circle and a line are given in a plane, and number of tangents possible from a point, and the length of tangents. What do we mean by a plane, a line, a circle? Suppose, if I draw my coordinate axis like this, this is my plane. This is my plane. Otherwise, the whole frame out of here is a plane. This is called XY plane. And in this plane, if I draw a circle or a line randomly, their characteristics, behavior, and all is what we're going to study in this lecture. Different situations that can arise when a circle and a line are placed in a plane are, they might not be intersecting, which I've just shown you above, just touching, or the line is called a tangent to the circle, or intersecting each other forming a secant. Tangent to a circle is a line that intersects the line only at one point. If it is clearly visible to you over here, the line is intersecting the circle only at one point. Tangent to a circle is a special case of the secant when two ends of it corresponding chords coincide. That is the third case. If I consider a circle like this, and if I pass a secant like that, it cuts the circle at two points. So it's a chord. Otherwise, as I've shown you earlier, they can be anywhere. They are not intersecting at all. We have a theorem, rather a condition to be observed and kept in mind while dealing with circles. It is, the tangent at any point of a circle is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. Let's see it pictorially. If this is my circle and this is its center, tangent at any point of a circle, suppose this is the point through which my tangent passes. Remember, this will be my second case. Then, tangent at any point of a circle is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. This is my point of contact, this is my center, and this will be my radius. So, if I extend this like this, isn't this at 90 degrees? That is what he is trying to say. Number of tangents, similarly, if I draw a line over here, everything subtends a 90. Let's continue. Number of tangents from a point to a circle. A point may be inside the circle where no tangents are possible. A point may be on the circle where only one tangent is possible through the point, and a point may lie outside the circle on the plane from which two distinct tangents are possible. Suppose if I consider a circle and a point over here, I have no tangent to be drawn from here. No tangent can be drawn from here. Suppose if I have a point on the circle which satisfies the equation of the circle, I repeat, satisfying the equation of the circle will make the point lie on the circle. Please remember, from here I have only one tangent passing through this point. If I have a point somewhere in outer space, then I have two tangents of equal length cutting the circle. Theorem 2. Let lengths of the tangents drawn from an exterior point remain the same. That is what I was explaining to you in the previous diagram. This could be proved by using Pythagoras theorem as discussed earlier. Okay, I just converted my diagram into a neat geometrical figure over here. I have the points O, P, Q, R and C. Let me just change my ink color. Yeah, so O, Q, P, R and C. OQ and OP are the lengths of my tangents, and OR is the perpendicular which is drawn from Q to P, and CR is my length, and this is the center of my circle. This construction shows two similar triangles made out from the two tangents where OQ and OP are the lengths of the tangents. Here my triangles are OQC and OCP are my two similar triangles over here. Another important note you must make in this chapter is that the angle subtended by the two tangents, that is this angle, the angle subtended by the two tangents is equal to twice the angle of RQC, RQC. These points are to be well noted so that you proceed fast during the examination. You can as well derive these equations as they are not so tough. They are just geometrical based questions. I can prove this by angle side angle or angle 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 relation, and I could prove them similar. In order to find the OR length or RC length, people in examination might ask you to find out OQ length, OP length or OC length. You can consider each triangle particularly at separate time and solve them using trigonometric ratios, angles and standard angles. Thank you. Hope you understood.